Please welcome Kate Cebrano.
Thank you. I tell you, it's much easier doing a live gig, actually, than having to do this stuff. I was just standing in the corner over there and they were saying, look at this. I'm like, my little heart's just going dun, 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 dun. I haven't seen you guys since before COVID.
Yeah. Well, that's true for...
We look a bit different, don't we?
Yeah. All of us look a little different, I reckon. I think we look a lot more, dare I say it, sort of settled in our skins. Like, things, I don't know about you guys, but I certainly take life a lot more seriously than I did before COVID. Yeah. Every single thing I just love passionately and deeply. And hello, who are you?
My name's Ted. Lovely to meet you.
I thought you must have been looking at me going, what happened to Peter Hellyer?
Well, it's true. There's the old guard, but now you're the new guard.
Oh, yeah.
I dub you the new guard. Oh, there you go.
Might I remind you, you've been married for 27 years.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
To
that's
your
right.
husband.
Sorry, can I just remind Sam that between the two Kates, aren't you meant to have a girlfriend?
I do. I have a girlfriend. Jules, if you're watching.
Yes.
And it's all fake.
Look, what a sandwich, Chaunton.
Yeah. It's also not good that I had a rose ready
it's
to go.
It's actually really beautiful because it's there's a kind of toy song that I made my career off of called Young Boys Are My Weakness.
Yes.
Oh. And yes. So it's just a cute sort of, I know. It's so, you, I go to, look, I get threatened to sing it. I get threatened. That's a terrible way of describing it. Then I'm going to go to jail if I sing it. So I don't sing it very often. That's what I wanted to say.
Right, okay, well, great. Let's talk this album. You are here for a reason.
I
not
am.
To continue with the flirting.
No, I wasn't. Oh. Well, thank you so much.
Now, what was it like? What was it like working with a full orchestra on this album?
Well, as you can imagine, you know, it's got the power of an ocean. It's not like playing with a band. You've got, like, the timing's really different with an orchestra. We go in a band, like, 2, 3, 4, boom, boom, cack, boom, 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 cack, boom, boom. An orchestra goes, well, so when you're sitting in there and I must say, as a pop singer, sometimes we don't rate ourselves in any orchestral sense, of course, and it makes sense.
Yeah, right.
How would three chords be illustrated in a cast of, like, over 80 players?
Yeah.
And they're people that have lived their whole lives to get half good at this stuff. And so it's almost an insult when you come in, you're like, you know, yeah, could you just play just that one there? See, that's got a D. But you realise that actually they are symphony orchestras. They are this standard, and somehow they gave me an opportunity to be in that ocean with them, and I was bobbing along as happy as a cork. And I just, at some point during the recordings, at some times I got so overwhelmed I'd have to just stop and sob with the beauty of it. It was just too beautiful.
Oh,
wow.
It was just too beautiful.
You look like you can't believe what you're doing.
Oh, well, the brief was, I said to my friend Roscoe, I want Edward Scissorhand, Polar Express, West Side Story. Is that too much to ask for? And I said, because this is the sound of my life, right? Yeah. This is how I was born. I was born with this music that would enhance my life, whatever gritty reality I was living. I would go to those places and it would make my life seem like a symphony. And so he gave me these things. I can't wait to show the whole album.
And you share the gift. But how do you explain Pash to the kids?
Willy Wonka in the Chocolate Factory.
What? Did it happen? I don't remember that scene.
You know, how do you explain the word? You mean colloquially?
Yeah, because it's changed, hasn't it?
These days?
Oh, yeah. Sorry, I was so deep into the composition aspects of it, I forgot that I was actually here to promote my own song, which is Pash. Yeah, OK, Pash, first of all, let me just... It's Valentine's Day, so let me take you back to the beginning. Pash, for those kids who haven't yet experienced it, it's the point where a kiss becomes your life's ambition.
Oh, that's beautiful.
It's your life's ambition to chase this feeling that makes the world seem like a place worthy of wanting to grow up in. It's a feeling that makes, you know, the trials and the failures, for instance, make sense, and that you just keep going to go for that. Like my husband, for instance, 27 years, we've been together. Quite simply, he was the greatest kisser I ever met.
Oh!
Hang on, you haven't met Sam talking.
Yeah. And Pembroke knows from experience as well.
You have very deep conversations with your kids, I'll tell you that. Kat's brand new album, My Life is a Symphony, is available for pre-order now. For info on how you can catch her on tour around the country, please head to our website. Kat, thanks so much for dropping in. Yeah.